Good afternoon, Emily and Nate. On behalf of the parish of St. Robert, I want to welcome you both. Welcome your parents and grandparents and relatives and friends who are all gathered here to celebrate your love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My friends, let's pause briefly expressing our appreciation and gratitude for the great mystery we call God. Thanking God for God's continued love, mercy, and forgiveness. Thanking God for Emily and Nate and the love they share with one another. And thanking God for the love that we experience in our own lives. Would you repeat after me, please? The light of God surrounds us.
The light of God surrounds us.
The love of God enfolds us.
The love of God enfolds us.
The power of God watches over us.
The power of God watches over us.
The presence of God is within us.
The presence of God is within us.
Wherever we are, God is.
Wherever we are, God is.
Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these, your servants, Emily and Nate, that coming together before your altar, that they may be confirmed in love for one another, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Now, please be seated for the first reading, which will be done by Logan Upshaw.
A reading from the book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah arose from the bed and said to his wife, "Get up, let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and to grant us deliverance." Sarah got up and they started to pray and begged that deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Praise be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam and you gave him his wife Eve to be his help and support. And from these two, the human race descended. He said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself.' Now, Lord, we know that I take this wife of mine, not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and on her, and allow us to live together a happy old age." They said together, "Amen, amen." The word of our Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our second reading will be done by Olivia Bednar.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
I'm not exactly sure how long ago it was, but the Bednars are always in church at the 9 o'clock Mass. And this time, there was another gentleman along that crowd. And after I said, "Andy, who's this guy here, huh?" He said, "Nate." And I think that Nate, in my opinion, is that when he saw Emily for the first time, he reminded me of a great song of Bruce Springsteen, and this is one of my favorite songs, "You Are the One." And I think that he thought, "This is the one I'm going to marry." And I think she thought, maybe herself, that I think I want this guy too. Huh? Beautiful couple. Beautiful couple. When I go back with the Bednars, Lord, about 32 years, And so I've seen this beautiful girl at her birth. I baptized her. She went to communion here, confirmation. Of course, they're in church every Sunday. And she went to Holland High School, where she was on the honor roll. And she was almost all in drama. And I know a couple times I went to see her in drama, and she was in summer stock. I really never went to summer stock. Maybe I didn't know about it, but Andy should have told me I went to see her. I did go to summer stock when Michelle was in summer stock. So she was an honorable student and also good in debate. What's that? Are you good in debate? So you know you're going to lose all over the hall. And she went to Boyne, got a degree for education, went to Walsh College, and got a master's, and she's teaching over at Jefferson, where her cousin is. Freddie started that out there with his band. You know, play the night, Freddie, with your band. She's not only a beautiful woman, she's very disciplined. She's a perfectionist. She wants everything to be just so. She's extremely loyal. And it's just the simple things that make her happy. She maybe has a tendency to worry a little bit too much. But no, you don't need to worry. She's very smart. And interestingly, these are the kind of people that you want teaching your children in today's world, like Emily. Now, I can't go all the way back to you. I go to most of the high school of Lakeview stuff, and Nate was in the band, and he was a tuba player, and even if you went there, you couldn't see him anyway with the tuba. So then he went on to Youngstown State and got a degree in mechanical engineering and technology. And he currently works at the compression design. That's what it is. That's where he currently is employed. Well, you know, he's a smart man himself. Not only that, I think he has a lot of hidden talents, and he's going to start understanding his hidden talents as he grows through and growing through life and living life together with Emily. He certainly can discern a friendship, a relationship right away. That's what I said in the beginning, how he discerned who he really wanted to marry when he saw Emily. He basically is competitive. He strives to be successful and does his best in all things. So, both of you, you're a beautiful couple. Now, we're going to look what the scripture articulates and what the scripture says on this beautiful ceremony and celebration. The first reading talks about prayer. And again, I'm going to refer to Bruce. Bruce has this album out. Any Bruce fans are out there? Any Bruce fans? Yeah. All right. Some of the younger people, get with it. It's been 50 or 60 years, man. Bruce in his album, A Letter to You, and we'll get to that letter after a while, but he says there's power. One song is the power of prayer, powerful, the power of prayer. And those of you who are, I think you're all people, realize that black is prayer powerful because it's positive. There's nothing negative about it, it's positive. That's why the power of prayer, and keep prayer and God in your life. It's extremely important. That's what the first reading articulates. The second reading articulates love. We can all talk about love. You can love a lot of things, but in this experience of making a commitment, it's all in your heart. Your love is coming from your heart and working for the unconditional love that God has for each one of you, as he says in the gospel. God, we are God. God is, they're one in each other and one in us. This great mystery we call God is present within each one of us. In the beginning of the Big Bang, when the end incarnation, the great mystery called God, through his mind, explodes with the so-called Big Bang. The principle of God is in everything of the universe, and especially in us. And this principle is love. God loves us, cares for us. And so the big letter that I'm going to send to you is a letter inside saying that the great mystery of all God, Jesus, loves you both, is always there in your life. Refer to Jesus all the time in your life and God. And through that whole process of your loving one another, going through great times, there are also difficult times. And realize that that mystery is always there, loving you and caring for you. And my real dream and hope is that you continue to grow in your love for one another as you continue to live life together. God bless you both. My friends, Emily and Nate, you've come together into this house of the church, so that in the presence of myself, the church's minister, and the community of people here who love you, your intention is to enter into marriage. May you be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly bless the love that binds you to the special sacrament he enriches and strengthens you, that he has already consecrated by holy baptism, and that you may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life, so that in the presence of all of us, I ask that you state your intentions. Emily and Nate, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely, and wholeheartedly?
We do.
Emily and Nate, are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other as long as you both so live?
Yes.
To love you, and honor you, all the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Emily.
Oh, Emily.
Oh my gosh,
it's your turn. Emily, I take you, Nate, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
May the Lord in his kindness strengthen this consent that you have declared before all of us and graciously bring to fulfillment the blessings within you with what God has joined, let no one put asunder. Lord, bless and sanctify Nate and Emily in their love for one another. And let these rings be a sign of their faithfulness. Remind them of their love for one another through Christ our Lord. Emily, accept this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. Nate, accept this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image, and will that the union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you, for these your servants, Emily and Nate, who are joined today in the sacrament of marriage. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come upon this bride, Emily, and upon Nate, her companion for life. And may the power of your Spirit set their hearts aflame on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may reflect your presence in today's world. In happiness, may they praise you, Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray you in the Holy Assembly, and greatest you in the world, and for a happy old age, together with this circle of friends and surrounding them, they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ.
Amen.
At this time, the bride and groom will mix two species, two spices, symbolic of uniting of their lives. Once mixed, two flavors can never be separated. Now they have chosen basil, which represents happiness and love, and oregano, which signifies joy and appreciation. This time we're going to have the presentation of the gifts that William A. Burton Jr., Fred F. Brazier, and Katie Hansen. To introduce to you now, Nate and Emily Hansen.